What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. In this video, I've got another extremely important AMC update to bring all of you. So I apologize in advance for maybe not sounding as upbeat as I usually do. I got my second shot yesterday, so I'm feeling pretty miserable right now, but I was able to find a lot of really important information that I want to bring to your guys' attention. We have some very interesting things happening with the option chain right now that I want to fully explain to you guys, and there is something going on that if you guys are doing this, you should definitely stop right now. We also have the cost to borrow number spiking on both of our sources, Ortex and iBorrowDesk. The reason I like to look at iBorrowDesk is because it also tracks the amount of shares that are available to be shorted at the current time. And again, when I look at all of the different Ortex numbers or even iBorrowDesk or Fintel, I'm typically just looking at the trends. Even though Ortex is supposedly covering 85% of all of the brokers, I still always try to take it with a grain of salt and just look at the longer term trends that we are seeing. So before we get into all of this interesting information, if you guys would like to earn two free stocks with Webull valued up to $1,850, make sure you check out that link down below in my description. So today, AMC is up again with the overall broader markets trending downward. We are up at the current time that I am recording this video about 2.75%, and the stock is trading at $10.34. Now let's come over to the option chain. And I'm going to explain exactly what is going on here. So this is going to be the May 14th expiration date for 2021. So this is going to be the expiration date that happens in 2 days. Now, when we're looking at this option chain, there's always the potential for a slight gamma squeeze at this $11 mark, since we have this 32,027 open interest, which means that is the amount of contracts being held in people's brokerage accounts at the current time. Now, that definition is going to be very important when we come down here. So we can see that there is a almost 15,000 contract open interest. That means that 15,000 contracts are being held at people's brokerage accounts for this $20 strike. And we can see that 7,000 about contracts are being held at this $24 strike. Now, think about who you are buying these contracts from. If you guys are buying these super deep out of the money AMC contracts, hoping that the short squeeze will happen this week, next week, or you keep buying these weekly expiration dates, think about who you are giving this money to. Typically, when you are buying options contracts, you are buying them from an institution or a market maker that is selling these options. What you're essentially doing here is handing away free money. Now, nothing that I say in these videos is financial advice. These are for educational and entertainment purposes only, but I think that everybody is going to be much better off buying and holding shares of AMC for the long term when this squeeze plays out. Now, you also have to think about a couple of things. If you still want to buy these options contracts, that is your decision. You can do whatever you want. You just have to keep in mind that you technically are basically handing money over to these institutions. Now, if you do get lucky and the squeeze happens between the time that you bought these options contracts and the time that the contracts actually expire, and we see AMC get up to the price levels that we expect it can, so 1,000, 5,000, 10,000, even 100,000 per share, you have to think about the market for these actual options contracts. They're going to be extremely illiquid, meaning it's going to be very hard to actually sell the actual contract. Now, if you bought a lot of these options contracts, you are most likely going to have to exercise these contracts, and you're going to need a lot of money to do so. So that's going to wrap up the section on options. If you guys didn't understand everything fully that we went over in this section of the video, make sure you comment down below and I will do my best to answer all of your questions. Now, when we come over to Ortex right here and we zoom in at the cost to borrow minimum is going to be 126.32%, the cost to borrow average 246.85%, and the max cost to borrow 259.47%. This shows me that we are dangerously close to the squeeze happening. So when we come over to iBorrowDesk as well, they only really report from one broker, but we do see the amount of shares available to be shorted. So iBorrowDesk has the short borrow fee rate at 90.1% for AMC. Now, we did see the actual amount of shares get incredibly low yesterday, all the way down to 700 shares available. But seeing that these shares have actually run up a little bit, we can see that some people are actually returning their shares. This means that we could be be seeing the start of all of these shorts covering. Now, there's also something that I want to bring to your guys' attention, and we briefly covered this in my last AMC video, but I think it is worth noting again. Now, when we come over to GameStop section of iBorrowDesk, we can see that the fee right now for GameStop is 1%, but that's not really what I am interested in. What I'm interested in is this chart right here, this red line. We can see that on January 8th, the short borrow fee rate was 22%. Now, a couple of days later, it went up to 45%. Now, we did see a lot of volatility in the GameStop share price. It was spiking up, coming back down, and then massively running back up. So we see the short borrow fee rate go back down to 24%. But let's see if I can come up here without messing with the chart. Then it shoots all the way up to 84%. Now, AMC at the current time has a short borrow fee rate of even higher than what GameStop's was. And we saw how high that GameStop went when it had its first squeeze. Now, I've also seen some comments on my more recent AMC videos that some people are losing hope in this cause. Now, I'm not sure if these are just bots in my comment section. Everybody is entitled to their own opinion, so I just don't want to label everybody that is against this cause a bot, because some people may be new to this movement and have not been able to take a look at all of the evidence that we have for this squeeze coming. But all of the evidence that we have, the short borrow fee rate massively spiking, the utilization being basically at 100% for the past 2 weeks, meaning that all of the shares that are able to be loaned out by the institutions have been lent out. All of this is great news that shows us the squeeze is going to be happening right around the corner. Now, I don't want to give dates because I don't think that is going to help anybody, but I do think that this could happen over the next 2 to 3 months. Now, we also have all of these proposed rule changes coming in, which I think are really beneficial to the cause of AMC in setting off this squeeze sooner, but this could be the last massive short squeeze that we see in our lifetimes because of all the regulations that are coming in almost every single day. The last thing that I would like to cover in this video is a post on Reddit, but before we go over there, this is not really confirmed. This individual making this post on Reddit seems to have a decent track record of actually putting out factual information, but I want you to take this with a grain of salt. So when we come over here, we're going to take a look at this Reddit post. So when we take a look right here, let's see if it loads. My computer is acting very slow over the past couple of days. So finally, SEC investigating trading activity. Hedge funds are in more trouble with the SEC than we know. So if you've read any of my other posts, you know I'm a lawyer who used to work on Wall Street. My office was literally on Wall Street. I have a colleague I used to work with at the the NYS Investor Protection Bureau of the NYS Attorney General's office. He is now an SEC lawyer in New York City and has been for years. I finally got a hold of him. This is bigger than we know. There is an investigation into short position trading activity and its relation to clearing trades and market maker activity. This makes a lot of sense that this would be going on. We haven't really seen the SEC get involved publicly, but with the new chairman of the SEC, Gary Gensler, I think this is very plausible. Now, let's move on. So he would not tell me the names of the firms they have opened up an investigation on because he can't, but it's safe to assume it's the usual suspects shorting AMC. Now, that is one of the more bolder claims. Obviously, it could be, but you never know in these types of posts. So I can tell you this, though, they're looking at more than fines. I wish I could share more, but the SEC isn't going to tip off anybody while they are investigating them, just as the FBI wouldn't. But he did say there is activity that we wouldn't even know about that is playing with the share price. This is why fellow apes are always asking how we could be red or have such low gains when we have 3 versus 1 buys. So for every share sold, 3 shares are bought. Now, one or more firms, whether they be hedge fund apes, whether they be the hedge funds apes always mentioned or some we've never heard of, are going to be in a world of hurt. For some, it may mean they go out of business. For others, it could result in criminal penalties. Again, he assured me this is serious and there are other players who execute slash clear trades who have been cooperating with the SEC. It kind of explains why we never hear anything from the SEC. They are not in on anything with hedge funds. The new SEC chairman is not messing around. Now, I want you guys to take this with a grain of salt, but this is very good information if it turns out to be true. Now, there are a lot of individuals on these forums that you basically don't know who they are. These individuals could have some very interesting and important connections in the financial industry. I have actually been made aware of a couple of things in the past that I couldn't really talk about, but they ended up playing out and becoming public. And after they became public, public, I was able to talk about them. So this could be true, it could be not true, but we are going to have to wait and see in the future. So that is going to conclude this update on AMC. Again, I want to thank you guys for sticking with me through this video, even though I am not feeling 100% at all today. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys in the next one.